The baby was gone, the uterus was no more, and so was the marriage. All this replaced by endless urine. But life had to go on. Mine was more than a double tragedy. This is just one of the many outcries of many women in Uganda and elsewhere in the world, especially in the African continent. Theirs is a condition that is traditionally believed to be incurable, fistula. Visco-vaginal fistula, or VVF as it's commonly known, is a medical condition that results from abnormal communication between the urethra, the vagina, and the rectum. It is not only an awful and painful experience, but also leads to untold social stigma as its victims continuously dribble urine down their legs, wet their baits, and discharge an offensive smell.
Nali nkola mu hoteli kale bannongoosa omwana n'afa kale oluvannyuma lw'omwana okufa ate olukindo ne lutana ne mbeera ku kitanda omwezi gumu n'ekitundu namuzaalira mukyalo bamunsika mu busisi ne bantwala ekiwoko ng'olubuto luzimbye kati olwamala ne banjoza mu lubuto ne nfuna olubuto olulala ogw'omwaka ogwaggwa nezala banongosa bulongosa katukwe kufuna ekizibu kino nebantekamu akasege ebbanga lya myezi ena nakuba akakajjamu nalabira nga nfunye ekizibu kino
nafuna olubuto lulwatuka okuzaala ne lunuma ne bantwalako mu kyalo ne bigaana kwe kuntwala enaggalama ne bannongosa omwana ng'afudde kati ne nvaayo netandika okubonaabona nalo nga ndi wa jjajja kati ne bantwalako mu basawo abaganda ne lugaana kati ne mbivaako
ekizibu ekyo nakifuna mu 2022 kati nalinza nagenda ne bannongoosa kati ba ne bankoona kugundi kukawa kati awo ekizibu ekyo amazzi we gajjira ne gatandikirawo mpaka kati.
In a country whose majority population is poor and rural-based, nothing is more evident than the suffering the people experience. Their suffering may not be a result of their own making, but a diversity of many factors, including poor infrastructure development, especially in the health sector.
Experience psychologically unprepared, and biologically the body has not matured to handle. So you find that when these young mothers say have a big baby, it is going to push on the uterus and also push on the urinary bladder. And if the delivery is not effected within within expected time, then the baby tries to find their way through, even when it should have been removed by cesarean section. So, there isn't enough antenatal services throughout the country. And these mothers who get this problem eventually are referred to big hospitals like Mulago, because the facilities for repair don't exist in other hospitals to a large scale. So we are receiving many of these mothers, so we try to help them through that surgical procedure of repair so that they don't leak urine, because many of them, they are socially dejected because of the leakage of urine. And those who are married may miss out on their spouses. And also, it is not socially acceptable for one to leak urine.
The major causes are obstructed labor, especially for people who live in rural areas. A mother goes into labor, like today. She's taken to a traditional birth attendant. She spends there another day.
It are very young women, usually still 15, 16 years old. They might not yet be fully grown. Yeah. So the pelvis is not yet able to accommodate the baby properly, the head of the baby properly. So as it is an obstruction, this head gets stuck into the pelvis, and that is the cause of the fistula.
The biggest problem we see around here, usually these are young girls. And if they are young girls, it means they have not been to school. And if they have not been to school, probably their background is a bit poor socioeconomically. Because you imagine if my daughter is pregnant, even if she's 13 years, I wouldn't allow her to remain pushing for 2 days.
Want to deliver at home, or are being told to deliver at home, and are cultural factors who tell them to stay at home. There are tribal factors maybe who tell them, or you would like to call that cultural factors, who tell them to stay at home. They have to deal with the fact that a woman is not able to decide for herself. Yeah, I think that is the main problem.
Other factors include early marriages, from which young girls conceive before maturity. The uncontrolled and continuous leakage of urine is a dangerous condition stalking the rural poor, and when it occurs, in most cases, they are rejected by their husbands or close relatives on account that they are dirty and a curse. Whereas this is not about to end, something has to be done to avert the situation.
A situation in which she will be more or less a social outcast. Yeah, she's usually divorced by the husband. She usually, if it is the first pregnancy, she has a dead baby, so she has no baby. And then she's leaking and smelling, so.
Because once you get it, then, I don't have a better word, but some people say you become probably a social outcast, because you can't visit anybody, you can't go to church, you can't attend meetings. Every now and then you are wet with feces or urine, and therefore you need to probably isolate yourself into the bush and so on. And then the first thing, your husband chases you, because you know, probably no man who wants to remain with the wife smelling urine all the time.
In Africa, an estimated 50,000 to 100,000 women and young girls experience this condition. In Uganda, the condition is no better. But with the intervention of non-government organizations, these victims stand a chance to have their condition corrected. AMREF is one such organization that has embarked on identification of these victims and shedding some light to them at the end of the dark tunnel. Today, at least 250 patients with VVF are operated on annually.
The overall objective of this project was first of all to operate on women with VVF. We are targeting 250 women in 2 years. Then we want to train specialists. They could be obstetricians, gynecologists or surgeons. We want to train them to improve their skills in the repair of VVF.
AMREF's intervention is not only meant to cause a smile among faces that cease to have smiles, but is a strategy for training more health personnel on how to perform the surgery, as well as empower regional referral hospitals. This will reduce overdependence on foreign doctors, as well as increase the chances of women being worked on. More so, service delivery is extended nearer to the people.
And because the operations were luckily successful, more and more women came. And then I was also asked to go to other hospitals in Uganda, and the other hospitals were then Arua, Kitgum, later on Lachor in Gulu, and then again later on Nebbi Hospital. And a couple of years ago, I met Dr. Baragine because he would like to have more experience. He had already done operations in Mulago, but he wanted to have more experience, so more training. So I met him and I invited him to come with me to our camps in northern Uganda, in Lachor, in Nebbi, and in Arua. And so he spent with me several times. We have done quite a number.
Dr. Justus Baragine has been performing fistula surgery over time and is one of the AMREF's useful partners. He talks about his experience in dealing with VVF victims.
So once you've got the condition, it's not the end of the road. However, there is a small proportion who need to be properly, who may not heal completely. But if you access treatment early, and then you can have this fistula closed, and you again integrate in society and be productive. Think, educate these girls, and then let them know, because an educated girl rarely remains in labor. They are usually, educated girls are not so brave. They tend to be cowards, and as you know, cowards live longer, though they die many times. So once they are in labor, they tend to go and seek medical care early, and then they are the people who know where the care is. So you educate them, then they will know that there is actually a way to prevent these obstructed labors. They will seek medical care.
So the good part of these camps or the VVF repairs is that most of them at least improve. Most of them have improved. There are very few who don't get it the first time, but when they come the second time, they can still get a chance of healing totally. Others even come on the third type, they are worked on and also can improve.
And since the condition mainly affects the rural poor, which constitutes 80% of the East Africa's population, where medical services are minimal and do not exist in some instances, AMREF has undertaken a Herculean task to address the problem of fistula.
But for the woman, who is suffering from this condition, for her it is a big problem. Because it is for her a situation in which she will be more or less a social outcast. She's usually divorced by the husband. She usually, if it is the first pregnancy, she has a dead baby, so she has no baby. And then she's leaking and smelling. So where will she stay in the village? Where will she stay? She has to go back to her parents and wait for the operation. So it's for her, for the woman, for the patient, it is a very big social end.
So we're really trying to combine the curative, but also to combine it with the health education. But you know, for us, we are not, our mandate is not health education. Our mandate is to treat. So we have to liaise with the ministry, because they have the larger mandate. Then the AMREF, World Health Organization, UNICEF, and others are all assisting in passing this message through. But as it is, they see a very big problem. This message is not yet going through. It may also be complicated by socio-economic factors. Whatever there is poverty, whatever there is political instability as we've had in the north, pregnancy is bound to occur in unsatisfactory circumstances, merely because the people are not well settled. Those who would be going to school may not be going to school. Parents may not be available. Parental guidance may not be available. And in a situation of a camp, you have all these kids, boys and girls, mixing up, and with little control because there are so many, and the parents are also distressed. So these are the issues which are complicating the production issues, and also complicating the level of care for mothers, especially those who are getting pregnant for the first time and are young and unprepared.
Whereas the above can be solved by this project, AMREF is in contact with government and all the other stakeholders to ensure that they avert the problem. Robust healthcare systems, nutrition and education could go a long way in bringing a sigh of relief to the women in rural communities.
Previously, it used to be very difficult to get to access treatment. But as we talk now, there is what we call the National Technical Working Group in trying to eradicate fistula. They have established centers of treatment, and one of them is Mulago. Then the other one is Kitovu Hospital. Then we have Arua, we have Racho, we have Mbarara, and we have Soroti. And then these areas, they are providing treatment, both from locally trained surgeons and also from expatriates, like via the AMREF flying doctor service.
Because of AMREF's intervention, today 42 lucky patients have been successfully operated on here in Mulago Hospital, and now they walk back to their communities with pride and perhaps will resume their marital and conjugal obligations without fear. Among these patients are those who had lived with the problem for more than 20 years. The 38-year-old husband Nangabane fell victim of fistula while giving birth to her firstborn. She had an early marriage and gave birth when she was barely 12 years. The baby was gone, the uterus was no more, and so was the marriage. All this replaced by endless urine, but life had to go on. Until she heard of AMREF's free surgery, she had reached a point of self-pity and acknowledged herself as a social outcast. She had no illness, she didn't suffer any physical disability, but she did not attend any social event. She was indeed a social outcast.
Banne kya bangamara chitotambula bwa televanku za nenga chizibu changu
But today, she walks back home with a smile, the beginning of a new life, all thanks to AMREF's free service.
Banaye bachala banange nine sanyo pitirivu nyo mukinana mukaga nafuna ekizibu kya kongo nagadde omwana kati ekizibu ekyo nimbeera nakyo nganyo omusuli kati nensirika nakyo omwana nakola ki nafa kati paka nafuna bba wange omu kati naŋŋamba ekizibu ekyo tujja kikumira tubeera naye netuzaalano netunefuna olubuto tunyira mubaire naggalama ne baŋŋamba eri bujjanja nendiwumulanyira ne banongosa omwana wange nekirwadde kyange kati nensirika nembeera nakyo naŋŋamba wesirika abalwadde bangi naye gubeera n'ekizibu kyo ati nensirika tipaka lwakoze eki bwankuddeko naye nembeera n'ekizibu kyange nesikyogera ginyigira mulu kakati nali ndyawo ku lediyo kambulya zaitimu nabaterekankana te abantu babajenja babikiriki ningamba maama nakyogera ntya nesirika kati mba ndyawo ku CBS nebaddamu omwaka nebalanga sina sente ningamba
balange Masaka kubanga abantubasoka
nembawulire emulago ogwomwaka kati nga sirina sente nensirika kati nembulyako nomulamu ogwawano kambaawe bwolifuna sente oligenda kati mbandi awo yakadda mu ddwaliro nga balanga kugenya nazukuka nja nambuulira naye nenjiya pulaani nempakasa obusente bwange nagenda otutuuka eri abantu bati bayitirivu agenda nesimu ya muzei gesikol nga banabatukwatiddeyo yakukola ki yakukubira simu bagenda tukola kalinkubira simu kati musangayo bannange dokita bwe yali akozeeko oyo yankozeeko nga balamu nabaddayo nga bakola ki basanyu naye nekimpa okukola ki okuguma paka namukubira simu kuba nali maze ennaku nnya najja nkaa bagenda kukola ki ekiseera nekituuka nentwala mu sweeta nebannongoza bangamba ojja kumala ennaku wiiki bbiri era bwe zinaggwako nange nenguma ninda mu sweeta nebannongoza kati era wiiki bbiri we ziweddeeko ngaera batulabirira bulungi buli kimu tuziweddeko najja n'atukebera nga ndimulamu bulungi ngera bwe nali bakyala bannaye kyetantute ku kisoo kusabira nebazanya abasawo mwemulago nebalemulwali eddala n'ekibiina ekyo ate tebakomye ku ekyo tebandeeta ate tebakomye ku ekyo nebankwata emitwalo etaano nebagiika mukaasi era bagambye bajja kujja bandabeko nazeewo nga bwe nali
I'm on actress iyo yam uye esulini amba moya wam uye kobapo mkuu akokho kuphumula lapha emhlabeni ngisho bakhandazi mam sebenzetha umthandazo woxolo uyafana nje akuyafana.